Good morning and welcome back. You know, it kind of seems like lately, the last three videos, I think? Four? I don't remember exactly. The last several videos, I've started right here with a trailer on the back. And, well, in the world of YouTube, that is repetitive. That is a good thing. That means that I've done a reset, so I have a fresh 70 hours. That's the only time I come home. And I've already got a unit on, so I have, to some degree, begun my trip. And who knows how much further I've got to go. I mean, I've come home and had to go all the way to Tennessee and Wisconsin. And I've done resets at home and had to start that. This one is going to Oregon, right on I-5. So I'll have that done before I have to take a 30-minute break today. And then it's a 3-hour deadhead to my next pickup, so I'll probably end up sleeping just outside of that pickup tonight. And, from there, I guess we'll see what happens. Pre-trip's done. Streetwalker's warm. Now it's just a matter of getting on the road and getting down to it and getting things done. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'll see you guys sometime later down the road. Didn't really get a whole lot of filming over the last couple days. Got that one delivered on Monday, right? Yes, yesterday, Monday. I'm exhausted. Stayed up helping a friend with some stuff until, entirely too late. I only got like 5 hours of sleep. And then went up into Washington, picked up this Solitude by Grand Design, which, by the way, are very nice trailers. And now we're taking this down to Yuma, Arizona, which is convenient because I got a buddy down there that I haven't got to see it's been a while. Right after, not my last deployment, but the one before, obviously we deployed together, another tanker I served with. Anyway, so super thrilled to me to see him. And then I got a connecting load that is gonna take me back up basically to where I just dropped the last trailer at, so yay. So we're just doing this big loop thing. We'll see how it goes. I still have no topic for this video. I've got nothing. Now, and I'm sure that I'll finally end up with a topic towards the end of the video, right? Because that's just how it's gonna work out, I'm sure. And then someone's gonna complain,
well, it took you 12 minutes to get to the topic of your title.
Yeah. And if you watch more than one video, you'll know that I've repeatedly said that I start a video and I have no idea what I'm doing the video on, and I record clips, and eventually the topic of the video comes to me. Something happens on the road where I get to come up with what the title of the video, the topic of the video, is gonna be. So yeah, it took me 12 minutes to get to the topic. Sometimes that happens. Sometimes the first day on the road something happens and it becomes a topic. So you don't like it? Go watch someone else. I am so tired of hearing that from people. So there. There's the rant. Anyway, Streetwalker's ready for bed. I'm ready for bed. Gonna go inside, get what I need for tomorrow, and it is bedtime. With that, I will see you guys. I know I'm not making delivery tomorrow. I'm gonna wind up about an hour short, maybe two, because California's got their wonderful 55 mile an hour speed limit. and I was gonna cut through Nevada and just eat that permit, but a little bit of a snowstorm came through and certain places were throwing chain laws up, so I just decided that I'm gonna suck it up and go through California. Sweet. All right, I'm gonna get my stuff, I'm gonna go to bed. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Sometimes I miss the desert. So we're in Palm Springs, just outside of where I spent a majority of my military career, 29 Palms. And I had to use personal conveyance last night. So my GPS said, go down this road, da da da. I think it was on I-5, and then hook a right and get on this Angel Grade, Angels Garden, something, I don't remember, highway. And I was like, okay, well, I get up there, and 1 mile before the road, there's a warning, 4.5 ton limit. Well, Streetwalker by herself is over 4.5 tons. So I was not going down that road, which as a result meant I had to drive through Los Angeles. I hit Los Angeles at 10 after 5. So, personal conveyance is a big no-no. You should not use it. It's not there to get time, to get additional driving. Oh, if I can get a little further. No, there's days I've shut down with 40, 50 minutes left because there wasn't a truck stop past where I would have ran out of time. I mean, there was, but I couldn't have made it within without using PC. That's not what it's for. It's for things like there was an accident. I had to use that, actually, because there was an accident the last time I went through Los Angeles. I was going to stop at this Pilot on the Grapevine, and all of a sudden, there was an accident, and I wound up spending almost 4 hours doing what should have taken me 60... an hour, maybe two, considering it was Los Angeles, would say it should have been 2 hours, but because of the accident, it was almost four. I used personal conveyance there. And then last night, I was supposed to completely skirt around Los Angeles, then that road said, hey, you can't go this way. Now, I know Los Angeles has really screwed up traffic at 5 o'clock, but my intention was not to go there, and I got stuck in that traffic, and I ran out of my drive clock, so had to go ahead and crank on the old personal conveyance. Didn't have to use a whole lot, but there's a Pilot right over there, and by the time I pulled in here after 9 o'clock, it was full. Like full. So I looked at the map and I saw that this was just a whole bunch of nothingness up here. I was actually gonna park in that tram. It's the air tram or something, because that looked like an empty parking lot on the map. But I got there, there's a sign that says no parking. So conveniently, there's this giant place here on the side of the road. So I just went into it, and that's how we're starting our day. Now, my time should be up, because once you use personal conveyance, that counts as off-duty time, but you're not supposed to count it as your off-duty time. So I made a note of when I parked, and I ran my 10 hours off of that. So that should be up. I'm gonna go ahead and start my pre-trip, get going down the road, and I'll see you guys later. What a day. What a day. Okay, so we went and got that one delivered, the one that was right here this morning, right? Right, Yuma, Arizona. Got to see my buddy. Like I said, we deployed together. Great to see him. That's only the second time I've got to see him since 2016? Yes. So great to see him again. And here we are
in beautiful Las Vegas. I was trying to get here before the sun went down.
Didn't quite make it.
It just went down like 10 minutes ago. You can still kind of, maybe the camera will pick up. You can kind of see out there a little bit. But it is what it is. Anyway, I'll probably film again in the morning. But I wanted to touch on what we talked about this morning. Personal conveyance. Again, it is not for you to get a little further. It is not for, oh, well, I know I'm going to go through, like by situation, I know I'm going to go through Los Angeles at 5 o'clock. I'll just use personal conveyance. No, I was supposed to go on, I guess, Angel Garden, Angel Grove, Angel Field, Angel something, just north of LA. But it has a 4.5-ton weight limit. And if my math is correct, that's 9,000 pounds. And considering that as she sits right here, she is 10'4 and some change. She couldn't go on that road like this. Now, I don't think that I would get pulled over. I don't think that I would get in trouble. However, if I had that 39-foot fifth wheel on the back and went down that road,
maybe.
So when I saw that sign, I kept going, which then meant I was going through Los Angeles at 10 after 5. So that forced me into a personal conveyance thing. Not that I was trying to get further, but because I was unaware of the weight limit of a highway. And, well, it is what it is. I got stuck in traffic for 3 hours, and I had to personal conveyance for like 30-something minutes, 40 minutes, something like that. So, whatever. I didn't make it near as far as I wanted to. I was also delayed. I was supposed to have picked up here already, and I would have been 3 or 4 hours north of here filming this video then. So, now we're way behind. Now, my 10-hour break is going to become a 14-hour break. That seems to be happening a lot lately. And, we've got to pick this up and get it up to Eugene, Oregon. Thankfully, it's a Camping World and they have Saturday deliveries, because it's Thursday tonight. There's no way I'm making it to Eugene tomorrow. So, we'll get that delivered Saturday morning, and then we're going home. The final pieces that I have ordered for the bike got delivered today, so that'll be another video for Reset Channel. And after that, I'm going to drop it off, have some custom stuff built for it, and that'll also be on Reset Channel, I think. Maybe? I hope so. We'll see. We'll see. And, yeah. We have some issues with the Streetwalker. And we will address those in this video, but not tonight. I'm tired. And I'm still trying to process everything and make sure I'm looking at it the right way. There's some mechanical issues. She's getting old. We crossed 382,000 miles today. So, she still runs. Everything functions. There's just some stuff I need to address. So, we'll do that. We'll talk about that tomorrow. And, yeah, we'll talk about that tomorrow. So, I'm going to get ready for bed, relax, chill out for my 14 hours, and I will see you guys. Probably won't film at the pickup. I might. I don't know. We'll see. I'll see you guys sometime tomorrow. Morning, evening. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Okay. So, we were outside of Camping World in Las Vegas. Ignore that chiming noise. I wanted my lights on because what I'm about to show you. So, bear with me as far as that chiming noise. Now, the plan was to get almost to delivery tonight, because I still have almost 3 hours on my drive clock, and take off in the morning, drive the three and a half. There's a hole there. I have a light in my face. I couldn't see it. Drive the three and a half hours to get this delivered in the morning. However, we're currently about 5.5 or 6 hours or so from delivery. I'm in Susanville, California, by the way. And well, there seems to be a little bit of a problem. Now, I checked the lug nuts before I left. This unit had the spare tire loaded on it. It is a dealer transfer. It's a used unit. It is a... It's not a used unit. It is a 2021. So it could be used. I don't know. But it's a 2021. It was manufactured in 6 of 21?
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a tail end. I bet this is brand new. And it was... It had a spare tire on it already. So it has no spare. So that really helps my situation right now. The spare was already on it when I picked it up. And everything was fine. I went through the agricultural station to come into California. Everything was fine there. And then I looked in the mirror and I'm like, it looks like that marker light is kind of up. So I pulled over about a half mile down the road there. And I went, oh, that's a problem. That's a big problem. So I've got no spare. I got no lug nuts. And I am sitting here on the side of the road. And then, to top things off, the information that I've been kind of teasing in this video. Streetwalker's hurt. She's hurt bad. I'm limping her along. She's still fighting. I mean, she is a fighter, but it's not good. If you follow me on the Facebook group, I put a little teaser in there as to what it's doing. And that's not even the worst of my problems. Maybe the turbo is eating itself. I'm not 100% positive on that. I've heard some kind of weird noises, but I'm not really sure. It seems to be boosting fine. It feels like it's still making all of its power right, so it could be okay. I'm just getting a weird noise. I don't know. It's also possible that weird noise is a pulley. If you've heard in the videos, I've got a little bit of a pulley squeal. I'm fairly certain that's the power steering. It's kind of hard to tell. But I got that going on. I've had a very slight power steering leak. Like, I had to put half of the reservoir in it every month and a half. And it's been doing that for... Well, it started that in September or October. And I was just kind of letting it go because I knew that I was going to pull it off the road here soon to take care of the fuel issue that it's having. And, well, at the time, that was the only problem, was the fuel issue. I'm like, all right, I'm not going to bother ripping it apart because on these, you know, they have the weird power steering system. It ties into other things. So I didn't want to tackle that yet until I was going to go ahead and take it down for a while, rip things apart, fix the fuel issue and everything else. So that has now gotten to a horrible leak. I was going to limp it home. I have an appointment to get it taken care of on Monday. And we might be making some big moves. I don't know. We got to wait and see how things pan out, especially now with all this. Because I was supposed to be home tomorrow, Saturday.
So the day this video is released, I was supposed to be home. I'm not sure if that's going to happen now. Depends what happens in the morning. I've got a repair shop, like I said, coming out, and they're going to try and see if they can just replace the lug studs, or if they have to do the whole drum, or whatever. I don't know. So today is Friday the 18th? Friday the 18th. I'm going to upload this tonight. It'll be released Saturday morning, the 19th. And the Streetwalker is going down. Trying to get home before anything goes catastrophic on it. And she's going in for some surgery. We're going to get some major repairs. But meanwhile, I'm dealing with this. So I'm really excited for these big changes. Let's hope that they come out properly, that everything goes like it's intended, like it's planned. Fingers crossed on that. And, we'll just, keep pushing. And like I said, I'm really excited for what could be in the next video for you guys. So we'll start off with whether or not I get this delivered, whether or not I make it home, and then into this big news. I'm teasing you guys. Sorry, deal with it. That's what it is. All right, that's gonna do it for this video. I really appreciate all of you that watch. I really do. I know I've been short with a lot of you. I've ignored some of you guys' comments. Some of them are just because I don't know how to, again, when things get put into 5, 6, 7 videos and I'm still getting the same questions, I'm not going to answer you, because if you're not going to take the time to do a little research into this job and just ask every question that you have, then this job isn't for you. But those of you that do follow and actually watch my adventures, my travels, my chaos, I greatly appreciate you. I really do. And I've had a lot of personal issues going on that I haven't talked with any of you about. Well, maybe one or two of you that I know personally, but I haven't aired any of that publicly. And I don't know if I ever will. Maybe not. We'll see. But enough of the rambling, mushy crap. I really appreciate all of you. I truly, truly do. Watch for the video next weekend where, do we get this delivered? Do we get this home? And what's this big news coming next? As always, those of you on the roads, I wish you fair winds and following seas. Take care and have a great day.